Hello denizens of the internet, this is Kiera-Oona coming to you today with another segment in our Wheel of Time Craft Along Challenge. So for those of you who are not familiar with the Wheel of Time, it is originally a book series written by Robert Jordan. I started reading these back when I was in high school. I only ever got to book 10 because they were still writing the books at the time. And then they recently made it into a TV series on Amazon Prime, not sponsored by the way. So what we'll be focusing on today is the pin portion that I'm going to attach to the shawl instead of embedding it directly into the shawl for the Flame of Tar Valon, which is an emblem on the shawl which denotates the Aes Sedai as well as the White Tower or the White Flame of Tar Valon. So let's get started. This is what happens when you get frustrated when something for the project is missing. So I apologize for my frustration, friends, but I've lost the pin backings and I have been looking for them everywhere for like an hour. So I'm gonna take a break from looking for those because, you know, it's needed for the project. And I'm just gonna go into the top and the back of the construction. Hopefully it'll turn up because it's an entire brand new box and it's like this big. How hard could it be to find? Apparently very. What we have to do is we need to sketch out the white tier of Tar Valon. So it's essentially a teardrop. I'm going to use, we also don't want it super huge, but we don't want it too small either. That'll do. Is this gonna be perfect? No. Does it have to be? Also no. We're just gonna sketch out our circle. Good enough. And then we're gonna stylize the teardroppy bit. And when I find the pin backings, I will have probably two, so one for the top and one for the bottom. I might have a third in there for stability. We're going to use this as our template, but we're also going to use it as an insert for stability. This is essentially a piece of Bristol board. It's fairly stiff. I just need some scissors. These are just my generic dollar store crafting scissors. So I'm just gonna cut this out. Here we are. We have our craft felt. Because we are working with a front and a back piece, we need to make two of these. So we are going to put, like so, we're going to cut this ever so slightly bigger so we have a chance to tuck it in and sew it together. Before I get into cutting this, I'm pretty sure you all have questions in terms of what do I have. So I'm going to be using just some polyester thread, because this is what I have the most of. I'm slowly dwindling out my stash to use more cottons. And I also don't have silk thread, which is what most people would normally use for this sort of project. Other than buttonhole twist, it's really expensive. I don't have any. So we're gonna go with what I have on hand. We also have our collection of beading needles. This package has seen better days. And these are skinny enough to go through things like seed beads. I have a collection of various beads and things here. I want to have some of the pearlescent stuff in it because, I mean, Aes Sedai are fancy. We want to be fancy today. Shell buttons, but those might add a little bit of shine to it. Some silverish seed beads that I can split from the goldish ones here. And I've also got these silvery long ones. And then these brass ones here, I'm probably gonna save those for the Dragon Reborn, along with these gold beads here. It's really faint. I can see it, but you probably can't on the camera. And we're gonna carefully cut this out. And it's clear that my frustration is affecting my brain. I didn't cut this out with any seam allowance, so I'm gonna have to possibly make
this smaller so I can tuck all the edges in and sew it down. I mean, this could very well also possibly stretch out a little bit as I'm sewing it. If it does, it won't be that big of a deal. And yes, I'm just eyeballing this. For any sewists who live and die by using a thimble, I have a thimble. I use a leather one because I can never find a metal one that fits, and I know how to do leather working, so I make my own. And I also can't really stand the texture of a metal one just because it doesn't allow me to grip the needle with it, just for how I work. But I'm going to forego the thimble today, primarily because I'm going to be handling seed beads and trying to sew while using seed beads while using a really thin needle. I won't be able to feel the texture of it at all, so this will make it a little bit easier for me to navigate the use. I also have a tendency to hoard craft supplies. And as a reference, does anybody else do this? Just find random beads, throw them in a jar, and save them for later. From either projects that they started, or projects that they never finished, or just something that they thought was really cool. I know I've got like a reflective bead in there somewhere that the reflectiveness is wearing off. There's a bead that looks like a person here somewhere. I've got a cow head, it's all random. A couple of seashells, some sequins, some stars. Kind of fun. So let's... Why the hell do I have undrilled pearls? I also am not entirely sure, but I don't think these are fake. Okay, those are going to go away. Maybe I was going to use them to glue it onto something? I'm not going to use glue because I don't want it coming off. These were in my stash. I have no idea how much they cost. These are not very thick, so these are more decorative than functional. These are also a little cool toned, so they might not work. I've got all these other pearlescent sequins. I've got some that are just a kind of funky shape. Some of these are a little weather-worn, too. I may or may not use these, I'm not sure. Like, the shininess of the surface is sort of rubbing off. Yeah, no, that's rubbing off.
Once I was happy with the placement of the buttons and the fancier sequins, I started filling in all of that empty space with more sequins and some more beads. So I'm gonna let you watch the time lapse for the process of how I did this. This took me the better part of a full day's work. So let's get into it.
Eventually, I did find that package of pin backings. Thankfully, I found it. It was just hiding in amongst my sewing stash. Now that we've found the pins, we're going to essentially figure out how many that we need to stabilize the pin, so then that way it's not going to shift around too much while it's being attached to the shawl or when it's being worn. This way it's not going to flap around and make it look strange. We're going to make several slits into the felt to accommodate for the closure and the spring portion of the pin to be inserted easily. And then we're going to essentially sandwich this by tacking it down between the felt and the cardboard. We're going to sew the felt and the cardboard with the pin backing in the middle all together, so then that way it has a really secure structure. And the last and final step is we're going to take all those raw edges from the felt, fold them inside so then that way they are sandwiched with the Bristol board and everything else on the internal structure. We're going to use a ladder stitch to sew those side seams together, so then that way everything is encased, and now the pin is complete. We're going to attach the pin, which has all the pins on the back, to make sure that it goes onto the shawl nice and secure so that it doesn't move. And if we... That is... definitely not going to go anywhere. Thank you once again for joining me on this beading and crafting adventure. If you would like to see more content like this, please like, subscribe, and comment down below if you are working on anything currently. Keep in mind that I'm going back to school very shortly. I am currently enrolled in a garment construction and millinery course. For those of you who don't know what millinery is, that is the construction of hats. If you would like to support this channel financially, whether it be to keep myself caffeinated or to help with supplies for my next crafting adventure, or if it's to help me with schooling, please visit my Ko-fi page, which is in the descriptor box down below. Thank you once again, and I look forward to seeing you next time. Bye for now.